State title a few years back, and you still have buddies you call and count on. That's something you'll always have in common for the rest of your lives.
It really is neat. We had our 20-year reunion here in Columbia last year, and just to connect with these guys, and the common bond is winning a state championship, and it brings us together, and we'll come back for 30-year and 40-year reunion. So that's what I'm so excited about for all these teams that can call themselves state champions.
Well, and then you get to play in Mizzou Arena. I guess you probably played in the Hearn Center, right?
Actually, we played down in Springfield at the old Hammond Center way back. Well, it's been a long time, Neil, 20 years.
But these guys get to play here at Mizzou Arena. And like we said, this Class 5 game upcoming, it's going to be McCluer North and Nixa going at it. We're going to take a break right now. Thanks for joining us for Show Me Showdown.
Agents, what did we learn here today?
That lint balls are extremely flammable.
Well, yeah.
And that 15,000 dryer fires happen every year.
That's why it's important to regularly clean and inspect your vents.
Correct.
Where did you get that?
I built it.
We are insurance.
We are farmers. Bum, ba, bum, 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 bum.
That'll never happen.
I'll never wreck my car.
I'll never roll my truck.
Never happen to me.
Never.
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 Never happened to me.
7 out of 10 teenagers killed in Missouri traffic crashes were not wearing their seatbelts.
Never say never. Always buckle up.
From the gridiron to the hardwood. On the links or on the track. On the diamond or on the ice. Go to prepfilms.com. It's easy. You can order your DVD online. At prepfilms.com, you make the memories. We'll make them last forever.
Mirrors. Check. Sunglasses. Check. Seatbelt. Check.
What are you doing?
I don't wear my seatbelt.
Oh, yeah, because only cool people will wear their seatbelts.
I'm cool. Check.
Welcome back to Mizzou Arena, Columbia, Missouri. Show Me Showdown 2012. Our game upcoming, Class 5 Boys Championship, Nixa and McCluer North. Hi again, everybody. Neil Harwell along with Scott Highmark. And Scott, for McCluer North, it has been a pretty smooth road to get to this point. They haven't had much trouble getting here.
Yeah, they're very much battle-tested playing in that tough suburban North Conference. Probably the toughest game they've had in the playoffs is their district championship against McCluer, their rival right there in St. Louis. But from there, it's been pretty smooth, very workmanlike, but clearly their experience being here, winning a state championship, has helped them and calmed their nerves along the road to this championship game.
And again, only losing one game this season under their coach, Randy Reed. They're trying to protect the home court here, as they would call it, because they won the state title last season. So they're trying to do it again this season. You talked about smooth sailing. There it is. Look at those scores.
Yeah, it's their crown, and Randy Reed takes a lot of pride and has instilled that in his kids. Say, guys, this is ours until somebody takes it away. So they've got to come take it from us. And he goes, I don't think anybody can.
Well, let's hear it from the coach, Randy Reed, trying to come up with back-to-back state championships here in 2012.
Coach Randy Reed of McCluer North here. Coach, you get a career high and a season high from Byron Roy yesterday, 19 points. How big was his play to get you here to the championship?
Well, he's played great for us all year as a senior leader and a senior point guard. He runs my sets and he plays great defense. Couldn't have been more proud of the young man.
You jump out to a 15-2 lead last night. You were even better in the second half to run away with this one. How do you keep that momentum going here tonight?
Well, we're a seasoned veteran team, and we played here last year for a state championship. So we know it's a game of runs, and we know we have to keep our composure, and we got to constantly just keep playing well.
On Nixa, you said, hey, we're just going to get between the ropes, and this is going to be a big heavyweight title fight for this title. What are the keys here tonight? How do you feel you match up with them?
Well, it's going to be a game of runs. Nixa is a very talented offensive team, so we have to kind of take away some of their comforts or things that they like to do and maybe get it a little up and down game because we have a lot of athleticism. But it's just going to be a great game, epic battle, state championship game. I mean, this is the last game. This is the last battle.
All right. Thank you, Coach. Good luck tonight.
All right. Thanks, Sophia and Coach Reed. And he talked about he wants to play up and down.
Well, you know what? That's what Nixa wants to do, too.
Scott, they score over 78 points a game this season, and they looked really good the other night. They didn't have a good first half, but they had a great second half.
Yeah, 41 points in the second half against Marquette really stretched that lead out. But a lot of their 78 points per game come from three. They really like to shoot it over the top, and as you see, their road here to the championship game, that revenge game against Rockbridge, again, the only team that beat them this season, an overtime game, really gave them a lot of confidence, played extremely well, as we talked about in the second half versus Marquette, and they're not going to be intimidated by this McCluer North team.
Not at all, and they play fast. Coach Osborne told us that they want to play fast as well, so we're looking for an up-and-down pace here tonight. How about Rockbridge? They start the season. That's a good Rockbridge team. Nixa loses that game. Then they run off 30 wins in a row after that. They're now 30-1 on the season.
You know, it takes a lot of skill, a lot of talent, a lot of hard work to get here, but it also takes a lot of luck. And then talked to Randy Reed yesterday about, they said you got to get lucky. And, you know, an overtime game, you know, ball goes in, falls off the rim, a foul call here and there. A lot of things have to come together to be here and play in this game tonight.
And so Nixa the other night, after only leading 18-16 at halftime, they came out with a pressure defense. We know they can score it, but a lot of times they'll use that defense to fire up their offense. And they came in there with the guys like Reuter. He had six steals, a lot of them in the third quarter. And all of a sudden, they're off to the races. And they're scoring, as you said, Scott, 41 points in that second half.
Yeah, they forced 20 turnovers in that game. And they're really good once they get turnovers is they score off of those turnovers. They're very effective in transition as well.
Well, and Nixa has an outstanding coach as well. Jay Osborne in his 20th season. Let's go back to Sophia.
Coach, yesterday, a tale of two halves for you in the semifinal. You come out, you shoot 25% in the first half, but then you come out and you go on a big run there, 75% in the second half. What was the difference?
It's very uncharacteristic of our basketball team to shoot that poorly. I don't know, maybe a little nerves, big arena. Maybe it was Marquette's defense, I don't know. But we can't have that shooting performance first half tonight. If so, we might not be around in the game. But I think it'll be a little bit different Nixa team than you'll see. I expect us to make shots today. Our kids are loose, they're confident, and we make shots, we're in good shape.
Defensively, you came out with a full court press. You forced over 20 turnovers. How do you keep up that intensity here today?
Well, we've got to be a little bit smarter today. McCluer North's guards are pretty good ball handlers. They've got some quickness that we'll have to deal with, but that's the way we played all year. We've been aggressive defensively. We haven't been our heels. We've been in an attack defense and try to get our defense to score some quick points for us, and that's how we've been making the runs, and that's how we've won 30 games this year.
In 99, you were here. You faced defending state champion Borgia. Now you're here. In 2012, you faced defending state champion McCluer North. How do you handle that challenge here today?
Like I said, just have our kids focused and relaxed, and a lot of similarities between that year and this year, just what you mentioned, but a lot of things over the past 2 months have really come to fruition, and just strange things that kind of happened in 99 that are happening this year. So I expect good things tonight. I think we're going to play well, and it's going to be entertaining.
All right, Coach, thanks, and good luck tonight in the Class 5 Boys State Championship.
All right, thanks, Sophia. Thanks, Coach Osborne. And
You know, both those coaches seem pretty confident, yeah. Don't they, Scott?
Yeah, they're not backing off at all. And you just heard Coach Osborne say, yeah, they're going to come out and pressure us, but we've been in attack mode all season long. And I think he thinks they're best when they're in attack mode. They're not going to be passive. They're not going to take the air out of the ball. So it's going to be an entertaining game for us to watch.
Yeah, you know, you get to this point in the season, you've been successful, as both these teams have. Why change what's worked for you all season in the title game?
Yeah, unless you think you have a significant disadvantage or we can't guard a particular guy, or if you think the other team has better talent, sometimes you say, let's make four or five passes. But I don't think either one of these coaches are going to admit that, and they're going to say, hey, if we play our game, we're going to be the state champions. They're going to stick to their guns with that.
And both these teams have some talent. You know, you talk about McCluer North, and we look at them. They're from Florissant. They're in the St. Louis area, and their nickname is the Stars. Enrollment a little over almost 1,900. Randy Reed, look at all those seasons there. He's got the two state championships in 2007 and 2011, so they defend here today. And they've been to that Final Four three times, so they have the resume. They've been here before. They have some talented seniors. They know what's going on when they reach this title game.
Yeah, and I think it helps Randy Reed also having coached in this before. This is his third state championship game that he's been able to coach in, and just the calmness that he portrays to his team and the confidence that he gives them, and they've been successful in these games going back to Rez Roundtree and Anthony Booker and Femi John back in 07, and last year with their star player B.J. Young. You lose a player like B.J. Young, was one of the best freshmen in the SEC, and you get back to the state championship game, you're doing a lot of things right.
Says a lot about your coaching staff, a lot about your team to be able to do that. And Nixa, they've had their success over the years as well. Back in 2002 and also back in the late 90s, they made it here. They've won a state title before. It's just been a little bit longer.
Oh, they've been terrific. And again, kids that have some experience, they've got a lot of kids that have veteran experience, and I expect them to play well.
And right now we're going to pause and we're going to enjoy our national anthem as we get ready for the Class 5 boys game. Our national anthem from Mizzou Arena here at Show Me Showdown 2012. And again, glad to have you with us, Neil Harwell, along with Scott Highmark, and we await the Class 5 Boys Championship game. And we were getting ready to talk about Nixa just a little bit, just south of Springfield. So as Hillcrest will play later on tonight in the Class 4 game, Nixa just south of Springfield, bringing a lot of folks up here from that area, and they are fired up about their team as they play in the title game here tonight.
Yeah, they travel well, as will Hillcrest. 13 Final Four appearances for Nixa, so it's a program that's got a lot of tradition. Jay Osborne, having been down there for 20 years, 440 wins in his head coaching experience, 383 there at Nixa.
Nixa, the Eagles. Red and gray, got those gray uniforms on tonight. Jay Osborne has done a fantastic job over the years. Again, the state title back in 1999. They've been to the Final Four three times. Overall, it's eight times. As you go way back, 1978, winning the state title, and also 1999. So they would like to add to the trophy case here today as they take on McCluer North. We enjoy some of the highlights from the other night. This is McCluer North. That's what they like to do. Get out in transition. Get up in you on defense.
Yeah, they will turn you over, and then when they turn you over, they will get out in transition and try to capitalize. They're going to play through Jordan Granger on the block. They're going to make sure the big fella, the Auburn signee, gets some touches early and see how Nix is going to play them, because they should have an advantage with their size and athleticism down in the low block.
Yeah, Galen Brown right there is actually the player of the year in the league, and he has done a fantastic job this season. There he goes off the dribble. He's really their leader. He and Granger are the two leaders, but he's the guy with the ball most of the time.
Yeah, Granger gets a lot of the attention, but Galen Brown had 20 points in that semifinal win. He really does it all. He defends. He guards. He's a football quarterback. Great leadership on the floor.
And here's Nixa. They have a bunch of guys on the perimeter, Scott, that can go off the dribble. They got some athletic guys as well. Jalen Norman is the guy inside, 6'5 junior. This is Bundy right here. He led them in scoring the other night with 17. Here's Norman right here.
Yeah, they will spread you out, get in transition. Norman's kind of their post, and then they've got four guards, try to create space and shoot it over the top.
Jalen Norman and also Austin Reuter, their two leading scorers, did not even score in the first half the other night. They were only ahead by two. They both exploded in the second half. And Norman ended up with 16 points in the ball game, and he's pretty much a double-double waiting to happen every game.
Yeah, Norman 16-10 on the season, had 16-9 in the semifinal win last night. Again, definitely a Division I recruit. Whether he's high major or mid-major, he's definitely going to play basketball at the next level. And Reuter, I'm telling you, this kid can stroke it. If you like to watch shooters, which I do, watch Austin Reuter. He's got great mechanics, a beautiful release, had 11 points, 6 steals on the defensive end last night, and Reuter shooting over 40% from three.
Well, I know you were watching them work out, talking about Nixa, and you watch Mr. Reuter shoot. You're a shooter. I know you can respect another guy that can put it in there. Talk about his stroke a little bit.
Yeah, I'm a sucker for good shooters, so I went in the practice gym. I just wanted to see him shoot, and he's just got great mechanics, good rotation, follow through. Probably watched him for about 10 minutes, and he missed 2 shots. And I was trying to count. I think he shot about 50 shots from three, and he missed 2, and most of them didn't touch the rim. So he's just got... There you take a look at Reuter. He's put together, but he also is dangerous because if you get out and crowd him, he'll put it on the floor. He's got a little mid-range game, and he'll take it to the basket as well.
There's a little guy, Byron Ray. We look at the starting lineups. Byron Ray for McCluer North had his career high the other night, 19 points in the ball game. So there's another weapon you throw in there for McCluer North as you look at the starting lineups. Reuter, Hocklander, Epps, Bundy, and Norman for Nixa. Ray, Garrett, Brown, Holland, and Granger for McCluer North. And a lot of athletes on both sides.
Yeah, that Norman-Granger matchup is going to be a really fun matchup. Norman a little bit stronger, a little more physical. Granger a little more athletic, more of a finesse player.
Yeah, when those two guys hook up, I'll tell you what, Norman, like you said, just a junior. He'll be a big recruit next season for some college. Granger already headed to Auburn, and there is Randy Reed. Great coach here at McCluer North. Guy that played for Jack Hartman at Kansas State back in the day, back in the 80s. And certainly knows what he's doing here. He has been to this title game many times just in the last few seasons, trying to defend here. They won it last season in 2011. And they'll try to accomplish that back-to-back feat here today.
Randy, a Vashon High product. Wearing the pinstripes, the two-tone pinstripe, looking good today.
Yeah, he is. And how about Jay Osborne looking good over there? 20th season. And again, his teams have now made the Final Four 3 times. They won the state title back in 1999. They were also in it in 2002 as he brings his team here getting ready to go. Nixa and McCluer North. And Scott, I think we need to buckle up here. Could be a track meet in this one.
There's no shot clock needed in this game.
And right away, the Stars will shape it up on offense with Byron Ray, their point guard, 5'8 senior. Nixa starts in the man-to-man. This is Galen Brown, the player of the year in the Suburban North Conference. He goes right to work, and that one was swatted in there. It looked like Norman got up and got a piece, and it turns over to Nixa.
Yeah, Norman got a piece. And McCluer North likes going to the basket, but when you got an athlete like Norman, you got to know where he is. And here comes the pressure from McCluer North.
Yeah, right away. They will press you right off the bus. This time they back off a little bit, just enough to bother you, but they'll get aggressive with it as the game goes on. Shot from outside, and there's that shooter right out of the gate, Austin Reuter.
Do we tell you he could stroke it a little bit? I'm telling you, you better know where number two is.
And he has not been shooting it that well lately. He was 1-for-5 the other night. Oh, they go right to work with their big fella down low, Granger, with his first two.
They made no doubt about it. They said, we're going to play through Jordan Granger. And, yes, Brown's going to give us good minutes, but it's going through Granger, and they want to see how Nixa reacts to that.
He is 6'8", the senior, headed to Auburn next season to play in the SEC. Oh, there goes Norman, too strong with the shot off the glass, and Brown the rebound. And again, you don't need a shot clock in this one. These guys are getting it up in a hurry. And Garrett is working against Bundy as they lob it down in low to Granger, up over the top and scoring.
Randy Reed told us they don't think that Norman can guard Granger straight up. So Nixa's going to have to make a decision, Neil. Are they going to double Granger or are they going to play him straight up?
Losing the handle as he goes in. That was Jordan Epps that time. They call a foul as he takes it in. And that's some indication right there. Here's your keys to the game, Scott.
Yeah, Nixa wants to be one and done. They must limit McCluer North to one shot each possession. They must shoot the three ball well. They really rely on that three. McCluer North, they've got to limit turnovers. Nixa forced to 20 turnovers in their semifinal win. And they want to play inside out, as we talked about, through Granger.
Jordan Epps short on his three ball that time. From outside, this is Brown. Rebound battle four. How about Granger dealing it off Brown, who tried to sneak a pass down to the block, and it's out of bounds, and it will stay with McCluer North.
Well, see, Granger is really asserting himself early in this game. Norman's given up about 3 or 4 inches to Granger, so they're really going to have to put a body on the athletic Jordan Granger.
Yeah, we'll see that. Little jousting effort inside between those two. Follow that all night long. Couple of top talents in the state of Missouri. Here's Ray from outside. And the rebound taken away by Hocklander, the junior, as they quickly get it up the floor. Here's Bundy. Leads it back Norman. And again, even though he's 6'5", and he's a double-double guy, he can handle out here.
Yeah, he's a tough matchup for McCord North because of his size. They don't have Granger on Norman because they don't think he can keep up with him.
Hocklander, too strong. Rebound taken away by Brown. And quickly, they move it out to Holland.
Now, McCord North has shown a lot of patience, even in their semifinal win. If they don't have something, they'll set it up, run a set. You know, run 15 seconds off the shot clock. They'll show a little bit of patience.
And wheeling down the lane, but a traveling call on Tremaine Garrett. Yeah, I will say, I mean, Scott, talk about that a little bit more. We watched them play the other night. McCluer North, they want to play fast, but every once in a while they'll slow it down, collect themselves. Nixa, you don't see them do that very often.
No, absolutely. If you know, it would not be accurate to say McCluer North just wants to get up and down. We'll see later on, Soldan, that wants to do that. McCluer North will run, as we see the nice jumper on the mid-range game, but they also be patient on the offensive end.
Boy, I like that guy. He had 17 the other night. Cameron Bundy, the 6'2 senior, headed to Drury next season. Try to go down low to Granger, out of bounds. It will stay with the Stars of McCluer North.
And that's what you got to do. You got to get some help side defense on Granger. Norman's going to try to get on the side of him, but then you got to get some help on the weak side.
From outside, Galen Brown with the jumper, and he's on the scoreboard. A one-point ball game with McCluer North on top. On the pull-up, this is Epps falling away.
I mean, that's a tough shot. The lost art of the mid-range game. We've seen Nixa knock down two tough mid-range jumpers.
Well, and he's a guy they talked about really worked hard in the offseason on his ball handling, and it's paid off this season. They already know he can shoot it, or knew he could shoot it, and he showed you that right there at that mid-range game. Here's Granger falling away on the baseline. Tell you what.
I was going to say that was good defense. They forced him off the lane. They forced him 15, 16 feet out. Sometimes you just pat him on the rear end and say, good shot, big fella.
Yeah, not a whole lot you can do when the 6'8 guy's falling away on the baseline from 15.
And that's why you see why Auburn out of the SEC decided to sign the young man.
Exactly. From way downtown, Bundy's three ball too strong. Tipped out Granger. And he looks for some help quickly. And it's Byron Ray sporting those gold shoes again here tonight that he scored 19 in the other night. On the turnaround off the glass. And I think they gave him the hooch. That's Dorian Holland with two, and he's got another one coming.
Yeah, good-looking sophomore. That's one thing Randy Reed will do. He will invert his guards. When he's got big guards, he'll put them down on the block and try to take advantage. You see right there on the block, likes that mismatch right there on the low block, and the young sophomore strong enough to go up and finish.
Yeah, Holland, 6'3", and you had Hocklander down there, the 6-foot junior, and he completes the three-point play. And we've got timeout on the floor with McCluer North on top by four.
The MSHSAA would like to recognize the Farmers Insurance Agents of the Game, Jack Plug from Morrison.
Well, there's Austin Reuter.
Easy to spot people who participated in high school sports and activities.
Right on time.
They learned important lessons like leadership, teamwork, respect.
Hey, our meeting moved to 10.
We'll be ready.
Values that last a lifetime.
We need to focus on three factors.
Support high school sports and activities in your community. When kids take part, they get set for life.
Distracted driving. It accounts for 25% of car crashes. Music, cell phones, food, the list goes on.
This is why safe driving is so important.
Correct.
And it's why the best agents help safe drivers get a lower rate.
Oh, exactly.
We are insurance.
We are Farmers.
Welcome back to Show Me Showdown. The Nixa faithful have made the trip up the way here to Columbia. Their team in the title game, 30-1 on the season. McCluer North, 27-1 on the season. Offense so far in this one, Scott.
Well, we said they're going to want to play through Jordan Granger, number 25, and at 6'8", he's the biggest and most athletic player on the floor. See, that time Norman pushes him out 15 feet from the basket, and you see how skilled he is. He's much more of a finesse player. But again, Norman played him just about perfect, but sometimes just good players make great plays.
4 points in the paint, McCluer North. No points in the paint for Nixa right now, but of course Granger, he can go outside a little bit showing you that. And here's Bundy out front working for Nixa. Let's see what they get out of the timeout.
Well, you got to believe they're going to try to get Austin Reuter a shot. He hit the first one of the game here. He's coming off a staggered screen.
And falling down as he shot that one. But, man, the rotation, everything in the pocket as he shot it.
He's one of those guys when he lets it go and releases it, it looks good every time.
Here's Granger with a little soft touch and once again showing you that mid-range. And Granger has 8 early points to lead the way for McCluer North.
Yeah, we said he'd be a tough matchup for Norman. He's done a little bit of everything. He's been on the offensive glass. He showed you on the block, and now he's knocking down jumpers.
Shot there by Jacob Reuter, no good. Rebound Granger. Well, I've been surprised at how Granger has taken them outside a little farther. I thought maybe they'd work him inside a little bit more, but he's showing you that good mid-range game. There goes Bundy with the left hand and scoring.
Yeah, Cameron Bundy's explosive. Goes to the hole, finishes with that left hand, had 17 points in the semifinal game. Going to play at Drury next season. Good-looking athlete.
And we look again and watch. We talked about three guys they have on the perimeter, really, that go off the dribble.
Yeah, take a look at this little in-and-out move. It goes right around Granger. He knows the shot blocker. He can't go right into him. Just sidesteps him with the left hand.
Athletic, explosive, outstanding defender who can score from anywhere.
Interesting look this time by Nixa, dropping back to the 2-3 zone. I think they said we've had enough of Mr. Granger. We're going to pack it in and see if you can shoot it over the top.
I'll bet a few other teams this season have said that as well. Here's Ray swinging it around. And on the move, this is Garrett dumping it off inside, and Holland's got two more.
Pretty good execution by McCluer North, getting in that gap, making two, play one, and looking opposite. That's how you attack the zone.
Out to a six-point lead now for the Stars. Here's Jacob Reuter, younger brother, just a freshman out there, 6'5". For this Nixa team, off to his brother Austin, now dealing to Epps. Austin Reuter falling away, flying in for the rebound is Norman right back at him.
Man, you were a kid, you called that accurately, flying in out of nowhere. You see what kind of athlete young Jalen Norman is.
Well, Scott, he has to play a lot inside for this team to give him a presence in there, but I think you can see the skills he might be able to take outside.
Yeah, I think he's probably projects as a small forward, maybe even two guard if he works on his perimeter game.
There's a steal by Reuter inside. Jacob Reuter got the steal, and they get up and transition to Epps. He's one of those guys that can go off the dribble. Back to Bundy, surveying that defense.
You see how much room they're giving Bundy? They know how good he is at driving.
And he said, why not? I'll take it.
Guess what? Now you got to go out and get him. He's going to go right by you.
Bundy was six. He filled up the stat sheet the other night. Couple of assists, three rebounds, 17 points in the ballgame to lead the way.
You know, I like this zone, though. I like this look, and I would do exactly the same thing. And again, if they knock down threes, they knock down threes, but I like that a lot better.
Byron Ray knocked down a few threes the other night. Not this time. Out of bounds, and Nixa has it. 19 seconds left here, first quarter, and they'll probably try to play for the final shot here in the first quarter. And it looks like the Stars are going to go all the way back on defense as well.
You know, it feels like McClure North should have a bigger lead, but they're only up two. Nix has really hung around, been very efficient, patient on offense, had a good first quarter.
So the Stars pack it back in. Here's Austin Reuter, met there by Garrett. Deal it off to Edie, who just checked in. Reuter trying to go to work outside, spinning from the three line and banking it in. Have mercy!
The bank is open on Saturday night.
Now, I know he's a great shooter, but that one shook the arena. We look again as we head to break. You're watching Show Me Showdown. That's all right. Show Me Showdown 2012, the state championships here at Mizzou Arena. We're in Class 5 boys action, the title game. The MSHSAA Basketball Championships are brought to you by Farmers Insurance. Scott, how about the way that ended the first quarter? I mean, McClure North kept them at arm's distance almost the entire quarter, and then all of a sudden a couple buckets, one off glass from dead on by Reuter. 1-point lead for Nixa.
Yeah, McClure North's probably a little confused. They look at their stats. They shot 7-for-9 in the first quarter, had 4 assists, and they look up and they're down a point. I saw Reuter shoot 50 shots in the pregame, and he didn't shoot one off the glass, so I'm not sure he called that one.
Hey, when you're a shooter and it's going right. Three ball from outside. That one misses. That shot taken up by Damon Clemens. And here comes Nixa with a 1-point lead. Stars have played nothing but a man-to-man. That's what you see out of this club. Randy Reed's team backing up the shot for three. No good by Epps. And the rebound tracked by the Stars.
See if Nixa goes back to man. They're going back to man. I thought that zone was particularly effective late in that first quarter. Now they're back to the zone. I think Coach Osborne likes that look, and they can really pack it in on Granger.
And now the Stars are starting to fire from the outside, a little bit out of sync on their offensive end with that zone, like you said.
That's what Nixa wants them to do.
Bundy falling away, won't get the roll this time. How about the quick outlet by Granger?
Now you better get back in defensive transition because they get it and go.
From outside, three ball is short, high in the air for the rebound. Taken away there by Bundy.
Three straight missed, open three-point shots.
And they're 0 for 6 from the three line, and that one's going to go at 5:35 here in Columbia.
My man Cameron Bundy, when he has the ball, you better backpedal quickly because he's coming hard off the dribble. Watch it. A little crossover, gets in that lane, got that big power drop step and jump stop and goes up with the left hand. We've seen him finish with his left hand twice now.
And I've been really impressed in the two games watching Cameron Bundy about what he is bringing to the table. And his free throw a little short there on the three-point play. And timeout called. This is going to be a long timeout called by Randy Reed.
And I think it's a good timeout by Randy Reed because he doesn't want his team falling in love with the three-point shot against that zone. So he's going to talk about it and say, hey, guys, we can screen against the zone. We got to get into gaps. They're 0 for 6 from the three-point line. They're falling right into the hands of Nixa and what they want them to do.
Go back to what you were talking about with the zone defense, Scott. You liked that when Nixa went to it, and it seemed like they just started settling for the three ball. McCluer North did. Start falling in love with it, like you said, and that's been an effective defense so far for Nixa.
I've heard coaches say after they shoot an open shot and they get yelled at, they say, coach, I was open. And the coach said, did it ever occur to you that they wanted you to shoot? So it's all about getting shots for the guys that you want to shoot. And that's what Randy Reed's talking about. You can't lose sight of the fact that you still got to get Galen Brown. You still got to get Jordan Granger involved.
Yeah, that's a good one. You're open because they want you to be open.
Did it ever occur to you that that was their game plan?
Nobody ever said that to you, though, right?
Thankfully, no. But I might have used it on a teammate once or twice.
All right. Well, Nixa on top by three right now. Let's see what Coach Reed and McCluer North gets out of the timeout. And how about Nixa coming up with a little full-court pressure?
I tell you what, Jay Osborne's playing a little chess match here. Out of every timeout, he's showing a little different wrinkle. They've got a little pressure on McCluer North. See if they stay with it or just a little passive. Yeah, just a little passive pressure. Make him work to bring it up.
Coach Osborne, the coach of his son, or he's the son of a coach. Back at Nickerson, Kansas.
How about this? I love this. Then he calls a timeout to attack the zone, and Nixa goes back to a man-to-man.
Yeah, there you go. Fooling everybody. And Granger fooled on that shot. Here comes Norman. Little contact there. He goes on the deck after it. Everybody taking a swipe. The Stars come away with Ray. Dealing off to Granger for the sledgehammer.
Well, that's McCluer North basketball. Get forced turnovers and get out in transition and finish. They do as good a job as anybody you'll see filling lanes.
Norman short on that shot. Talk about filling lanes. Here they go. And Brown did not get up high enough. Norman fiddled with it. That'll be a goaltend as Granger trailed nicely.
Well, Galen Brown's going to get some trouble from his buddies about this missed dunk. This is the previous one, in transition, good spacing, finished by Granger. And then on the next play, Brown goes up, misses it, but credit Jordan Granger for running the floor and not taking for granted that Brown was going to make that one.
On the move, Epps up over the top of the shot blocker. Epps is 5'10". He's got 4 points now. 1 point lead for Nixa.
Boy, Nixa is mixing up their defense almost every possession. Now they go back to the zone. Important that McCluer North guards recognize that and get into the sets and remember what Randy Reed said at the timeout.
Oh, swatted away by Norman. And here goes Reuter dealing off Epps in the corner. 4-3.
They can shoot it now. We said they will attack and they get out in transition. McCluer North, when they get in transition, Neil, they go to dunk. When Nixa gets in transition, they spread to shoot the three.
And is all of Nixa here in the building?
It sure feels like it.
I mean, the earth is shaking here at Mizzou Arena. Nixa on top by four from outside Clemens, and that's a three.
Boy, that's a big confidence builder for McCluer North and Damian Clemens. Somebody had to step up and make a shot and make Nixa get out of that zone.
And what a big shot. Bundy right back at him. Too strong on the three ball. Saved there by Garrett. And here comes Ray, working on Epps, leaving it back, Clemens, back to Ray, short on that one, Granger has it and scores it, and one.
He's the real deal, Neil. He is the real deal, going after the basketball, playing with a purpose here tonight. And if there's any knock on Jordan Granger that you hear, sometimes he disappears, I've heard people use the word soft every once in a while, or just maybe not engaged. He is 100% engaged in this state championship game.
He looks like he's on a mission here. I mean, no question about it. And again, he's a guy said earlier in the season that they wanted to prove something, that they could make it back here without B.J. Young.
Yeah, it's incredible. Losing B.J. Young, is one of the best freshmen in the SEC, was terrific in their state championship game. And if you had told me that they'd be back here playing for a state championship, I would have said it wasn't possible.
Okay, Mr. Shooter, how do you like that one?
I'm telling you, the guy can stroke it, whether it's off the glass or straight in. What's your preference?
And coming off the screen, all in one motion, Clemens, not this time. Epps goes for the rebound. Clemens took it away. Heads baseline on the other side. Doesn't go. Norman was fighting for the ball, but it finally bounds out to Reuter.
We did say shot clock wasn't going to be an issue, didn't we?
Not even close. I don't think the NBA shot clock would be used in this game. Here goes Garrett the other way. Leaves it back now. Here's Garrett, the three ball, no, and the rebound, Hocklander.
So now they're 1-for-9 from three. Again, Clemens hit that one, but again, you don't want it to be fool's gold and fall in love with that three-point shot.
They're going to go four down here for Bundy and bring it out here to Reuter.
Yeah, a little flex. You got to love the flex offense. That elbow line jump shot, and that flex cut's always open.
Shuffle cut, and it's going to be Norman that takes it right into the lane and draws the foul. We've got timeout on the floor in this up-and-down basketball game in the state championship. You're watching the Show Me Showdown from Columbia. Okay. Norman missed two free throws while we were away. There's a steal and a bucket going down for McCluer North, and they've taken a one-point lead. We talked about Granger being on a mission. Scott, how about a double-double here in the first half? 15-10 for McCluer North. And we have a whistle here. And a foul on McCluer North. We've also got timeout on the floor with 2:13. We'll leave it right here. This one about all we thought it would be so far. One-point game for the Stars. And it has been an up-and-down basketball game.
Yeah, very entertaining. You know, Nixa really got in some rhythm offensively. Then credit McCluer North after that last timeout. They really came out, executed much better in the offensive set, doing a much better job contesting the shooters on Nixa. And then they're getting out in transition. They're forcing some turnovers, and that's where they're really, really effective. Getting those turnovers, filling lanes, and finishing in transition.
And not only that, I mean, we've seen all these athletes running up and down the floor, and it's not like they just rolled the basketball out and said, hey, let's go. These two coaches got a little chess match going on because the Nixa guys with Coach Osborne, they're coming out different defenses and doing things and changing it up. Coach Reed slowing the pace down when he wants to. I mean, you've got a lot of things happening here.
There are a lot of things happening in that huddle. I just thought it was great after the last timeout. Randy Reed, you just knew exactly what he was drawing up. He said, wait a second, we need to attack his own defense. And then Nixa comes out in a man-to-man. I mean, he's almost messing with Randy Reed and vice versa. But it's a lot of fun. And these players, you've got veteran players, though. These guys are smart kids. They're making adjustments on the fly. And they're really playing to each other's strength right now. And that's why we've got such an entertaining game.
And entertaining fans as well, as they're loving it here at Mizzou Arena. Class 5 boys state championship. Once again, Nixa to get here. They avenged their first loss of the season, which was their only loss of the season, in game number one of the season against Rockbridge. They won that game in overtime to make it here to the Final Four when they erased an 11-point fourth quarter deficit with a 14-0 run. And again, McCluer North pretty much sailed in here and haven't had to play too many tight ball games. But here today, we're going back and forth.
Yeah, 11 lead changes. How about that?
Go right into Norman, but traveling. Had a good look out of the timeout.
Well, you got 2 minutes going into the half. Just be interesting to see which team kind of establishes some momentum going into this halftime. Nixa falling back in that zone. Again, going to be content with making sure that they shoot it over the top.
Granger is just absolutely going to work here. 17 points and 10 rebounds in the first half.
Yeah, that's just too easy against the zone. You shouldn't be able to throw it to a 6'9 guy to make a play.
Austin Reuter got him another one.
I'm telling you, this is as pure a shooter as you're going to see at the high school level.
Almost got it. He did get a steal. Knocked it off of Clemens out of bounds, and Nixa will have it.
It's always funny to me that
he's got him a fat head.
He does have him a fat head. It always cracks me up how the defensive intensity always picks up once you make a shot. All of a sudden you make a shot, now you're all into the defensive end, and you saw that with Reuter getting out on the passing lane.
He has 4 3 balls here in the ballgame, 4 for 5, including at the end of the first quarter where he just jammed one off the glass from dead on. There he is with it out front.
Good hedge out that time by Granger.
Drops it off to his brother Jacob, and back to Austin. Not this time. Rebound taken away by Byron Ray. He leaves it back for Galen Brown, the steady player for this McCluer North team. And my goodness, Jordan Granger with another two.
You know, this is akin to the performance that we saw in 07 by another McCluer North player, Therese Roundtree, scored 38 points in the state championship game.
19 right now for Granger. Near steal out front on Norman. But he hangs on to the basketball.
Well, Reuter could shoot that one, but good discipline. 40 seconds left to go in the half. See if they'll hold it for one.
Right now it's a McCluer North lead by two. And it looks like Coach Osborne is going to slow it down. These guys don't have to do this very often.
No. About the only time they're going to hold it for a minute.
But they are shooting the ball a lot better than they did in half number one the other night against Marquette when they only led 18-10 at the half.
Yeah, they're going to spread the floor and let Bundy go off the dribble. See if Norman tries to set this high ball screen. They're going to try to get Austin Reuter off that double.
And McCluer North knows it. Austin Reuter. Little short on the three ball. It had a chance. And that's your first half. McCluer North in a track meet for most of this first half with a great performance by their senior star, Jordan Granger. 19 points on 9 of 11 shooting and 10 rebounds. He got his double-double about halfway through the first half.
I was going to say, that's a good night. Good job, Jordan Granger. You've done your job, and he's only halfway through. So effective, and not a whole lot Nixa can do. They tried man, they tried zone. He was just unbelievable and very efficient in that first half.
And let's go over to Sophie. Sophia.
Randy Reed, Coach. Jordan Granger has put this team on his back in the first half, 19 points already, over 10 rebounds. How has he been so effective?
Well, we're just getting him the ball in the right situations. You know, our offense is really built, you know, to help him score, and we're getting into it, getting him the ball, and, you know, he's getting his money, and he's playing well.
Your team has struggled from beyond the arc. They were at point, you know, 0 for 7, 0 for 8. Finally got things going a little bit there at the end. How do you get that three ball to fall?
Well, we got dragged into taking some threes, but they were from our best shooters. They just didn't knock them down. We got to go a different route second half. But you know, it is what it is. We just got to play better.
How do you get Galen Brown a little bit more involved?
Yeah, we got to try to get him some touches, but Granger's playing so well, we're kind of riding that horse. But maybe Brown can come through the second half and have a better second half.
All right, thanks, Coach. Good luck.
Thank you, Sophia, and thank you, Coach Reed. And we'll take a timeout with McCluer North on top by two here at Mizzou Arena. Show me showdown. Back right after this.
From the gridiron to the hardwood. On the links or on the track.
on the diamond or on the ice. Go to prepfilms.com. It's easy. You can order your DVD online. At prepfilms.com, you make the memories. We'll make them last forever.
Easy to spot people who participated in high school sports and activities.
Right on time.
They learned important lessons like leadership, teamwork, respect.
Hey, our meeting moved to 10.
We'll be ready.
Values that last a lifetime.
We need to focus on three factors.
Support high school sports and activities in your community. When kids take part, they get set for life.
And what's his
name? To the Final Four by defeating Bishani in 66 in the second sectional round and Vianney 77.
And welcome back to Mizzou Arena at halftime. Class 5 Boys State Championship. McCluer North on top by 2. And it was a very entertaining first half. Neil Harwell along with Scott Highmark. And Scott, it was just a lot of fun to watch that ball game. Again, I go back to the fact that we had a lot of athletes out there getting up and down, but the coaches were playing a little bit of chess with each other. A
lot of fun. Coach Osborne for Nixa changed up his defense quite a bit, confused McClure North for a little bit, but McClure North, to their credit, they didn't go away from their big guy, Jordan Granger. How about that line? 19-10 in the first half. He was unbelievable. And, you know, both really the stars for both teams, you know, Jordan Granger, and then for Nixa, Austin Reuter was terrific with four threes.
Now, Scott, you would think there would be a few highlights in that first half with all that running up and down the floor. Let's go right to it.
Oh, there were plenty of highlights. That young man, again, 19-10, got going early and often. Little jump hook over the left shoulder, posted up, little 16-foot jump shot, got out in transition and finished. Just did everything for McClure North, put his team on his back in that first half. I just can't say enough good things about the way he played. And then Cameron Bundy, terrific off the dribble, off the bounce, going to the rim. Two tough finishes with that left hand. He was really dynamic off the dribble for Knicks. A little mid-range game, showing us his whole package in that first half as well.
Yeah, he had a great job. How about that one going down? He went for the three-point play. Didn't make the free throw on that one, but very solid in the first half, Bundy, just like he was the other night when he scored 17 points. And then there's Mr. Granger that just went crazy with 19 points and 10 rebounds. And, you know, I was wondering, can this guy play at Auburn? When I saw him the other night, you know, the way it was going, not that I know everything in the world, but, man, he's showing us a lot here tonight.
Well, I've heard people question that, but, again, 6'8", very long, you know, probably projects as a 3-4 man in the SEC. Again, Auburn not one of the top teams in the SEC, but this kid's going to be able to play at the high major level. It, you know, you just can't teach kids 6'8", 6'9", that long with that good of a stroke and that kind of motor. That was the one thing that people questioned about Jordan Granger. Does he have the motor? Does he play hard all the time? He played extremely hard in that first half.
Yeah, he really did in half number one. And let's go back over to Sophia.
Standing by here with Misha, Executive Director, Dr. Kerwin Urhan. Now, Kerwin, for next year, typically we play our classes 4 and 5 on the first weekend of the Show Me Showdown. But next year, we're looking at some changes. Tell me about the format changes for next year.
Last year, we went to our member schools. We asked them if they want, like, the alignment of our championships. They felt that it would be better to play the class 1, 2, and 3 the first weekend and class 4 and 5 the second weekend. So beginning with the new two-year cycle next school year, we're going to flip to two championship weekends. So class 1, 2, and 3 will be played the first weekend and class 4, 5 will be played the second weekend.
Now, this was the conclusion of the winter season for these class 4 and 5 teams. We've got classes 1, 2, 3 next weekend, but hold on, because the spring season has already started. They'll start competition March 19th. We got a lot coming up here.
We do. They actually started practicing this past Monday, and so they're getting ready to start competition. You just go from one season to the next, and that was part of the issue for the smaller schools. Me and those kids play multiple sports, and this way allows them to be done earlier so they can be right into their spring season. So we're getting ready to start throwing baseball and running track next weekend.
This has been a great tournament so far. We had an outstanding championship game in the girls earlier today. This one's off to a great start. What are your impressions of this tournament so far?
You know, it's really been fantastic. Kids have played hard. You can see their battling from start to finish. We've had some outstanding contests, had an overtime earlier today. You know, these kids really want to play, and it's so difficult to see somebody lose a game, but unfortunately, there's always a loser and there's always a winner. But, you know, these kids can't be, there's no way they can be ashamed or hold their heads down because they fight so hard. They've done so much to earn the way to get to the Final Four, and they should all be proud about the results.
All right. Thank you, Kerwin, for putting on a great tournament. Neil and Scott, back over to you.
Okay. Thank you, Sophia, and thank you, Kerwin. It has been a lot of fun watching these young men and women play here in the state championship games. We've got a good one going here in the boys' Class 5. We'll be back right after this.
Agents, what did we learn here today?
That lint balls are extremely flammable.
Well, yeah.
And that 15,000 dryer fires happen every year.
That's why it's important to regularly clean and inspect your vents.
Correct.
Where did you get that?
I built it.
We are insurance.
We are farmers. Bum, ba, da, bum, 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 bum.
At halftime, McCluer North on top by 2, 31-29 over Nixa here in the Class 5 Boys Championship. Take a look at those stats. McCluer North shot it well, 48%. They have those 19 points out of Granger, 10 rebounds. What else do you see there, Scott?
You know, oddly enough, as fast as that game was played, not a lot of free throws, very smooth. Well-played first half. Again, McCluer North, as expected, doing a much better job on the offensive rebounds and on the defensive sides.
Officials also doing a good job of letting them play here in the first half.
And very few turnovers.
That's right. We'll take a break and come back with the second half action in the Class 5 Boys State Championship at the Show Me Showdown. And welcome back to Mizzou Arena, the Show Me Showdown 2012. Nixa and McCluer North, one half a play. And let's go back to Sophia.
Osborne, coach, incredible first half. It seems like your team was coming up with big plays whenever you needed them. Austin Reuter seemed to come up with a three, have that bank three to close out the first quarter. Cameron Bundy coming up with some big plays. How's your team staying in this one?
We've been a second-half team all year, and I'm hoping this third quarter is going to help us out. We got to get Jalen involved, and we've got to do something to keep Granger in check. He's got 19 and a half, so we got to do a better job of finding him, and I think this will be our half.
Any specific adjustments on Granger?
He's got to know where he's at. You know, he's catching where he wants. We got to do a better job know where he's at.
Defensively, you're doing some things to confuse them, zone, man-to-man. How effective is it?
There's no secrets. We're just going to play hard and make some things happen.
All right. Good luck second half.
Thank
you. All right. Thanks, Sophia and Coach Osborne. And, yeah, they do have to find the answer to Granger. And, you know, this is a lot like the game the other night. Scott, because Jalen Norman did not score in the first half. He only scored two in the first half of this ball game. So let's see if he gets going on the offensive end in the second half.
Well, that's exactly right. And that's one way to maybe stop Granger, make him work on the defensive end, get Norman more involved.
Shot from outside by Epps, missing there. And here comes Garrett out of the pack, the senior at 6'2". And he'll leave it back here for Byron Ray, who did not score in the first half. Guy coming off his career-high 19 in the semifinals. On the move, hanging and scoring is Holland.
Yeah, that's a good way to attack that zone defense, going to that high elbow, and if they don't come to you, take it right to the basket.
Here's Bundy, who had 8 points in the first half. Swing it back, Reuter. Left-handed bounce, wraparound pass from the top of the key is a turnover.
Yeah, that was a tough entry pass, and Coach Jay Hosmer says, hey, we're going to talk about that one. He's going to get after the young freshman a little bit.
Now, I am impressed, though, that a freshman is calm and cool enough to go ahead and think he's going to throw that pass here in the state finals.
Yeah, it was left-handed into a double team around Jordan Granger. But
that's a relaxed dude. The MSHSAA Basketball Championships are brought to you by Farmers Insurance. Well, both the coaches have a chance to make some adjustments at halftime. I know we've only had a couple of trips. We've played not even a minute and a half here in the second half, but have you seen anything that they've made adjustments to?
Yeah, well, clearly Nixa's trying to get, as evidenced by that last pass, they're trying to get Jalen Norman more involved. They want to get him some touches, maybe go right at Granger, you know, perhaps get Granger in foul trouble. That's one way to get him out of the basketball game. And Randy Reed, again, he said, we just got to get our shooters the ball and make sure somebody other than Granger is probably going to have to step up, because they're really going to put a lot of pressure on Granger.
Yeah, and that time they went and doubled down there with Reuter. We'll see what happens. On the move, Ray. Oh, nice little pass inside. Knocked out of bounds, though, as the defense closed. It'll stay with the Stars.
You know, I think your point's well taken. I think they're going to have to double-team Granger, and it looks like that's what they're going to do. Make him pass it out of that double-team, rotate, get a hand up, and see if they can shoot it over the top.
So the Stars have it from underneath their own hoop. Back to Ray. Went to the elbow and decided better. He'll shape up this offense. Dump it down, and there comes the help from behind by Reuter that time.
Yeah, not only are they double-teaming, they're going to him at the pass. Now, you don't have to double-team him that far out, but when he gets down on the low block, they're going to have to run two at him.
It's Wes Middleton that's in there checking him now, the 6'4 sophomore.
Yeah, another lineup change. Go with a little bit more size.
They get it to Granger. Shot missing on the side of the board, and here comes Nixa. Up top, Bundy. Nixa has no field goal since 1:47 left in the second quarter. So they'd like to get something going from the field here as they begin the second half. Stepping back, Epps. Baseball bounce pass in there to Middleton, and a foul is drawn inside. And that will be the first team foul on McCluer North. And this one goes on Holland.
Well, nice little screen and roll this time, and Granger gets caught in a mismatch, and good delivery that time to Middleton down on the low block.
Way outside to Bundy to start the offense. Here comes a screen from Norman. Bundy going to work, spinning into the lane, up over the top, shot no good, rebound pulled away by Holland. And here comes Byron Ray, and he'll back it out. Swinging around on the wing to Brown.
So you can tell McCluer North, they're reluctant three-point shooters. They really want to slash and get to the rim. That's more their game than just shooting it over the top.
Yeah, that was on cue there as Brown slashed in there. He's a wide receiver. Actually, a guy that's going to play football. He's a quarterback. There's a shot going down, and Reuter's got another one.
He's shown us how he can shoot it over the top, but he's also pretty dangerous putting the ball on the floor and can finish at the rim as well. Well, look at Middleton work. He's got some fouls to give against Granger, and I believe Jay Osborne said, hey, that's okay, as he gets called for a foul down there, but that's okay. You've got a few fouls to give if you're Wes Middleton. Keep working. Make Granger work to catch it down the low block.
The other thing here, Scott, is moving Norman off of Granger. And perhaps as they're working him more on the offensive flow, he doesn't have to work as hard on the defensive end. And kick it out high here to Ray.
see how Nixa's not really pressuring the basketball. It's almost like a pack defense. It's man-to-man, but it's a soft man-to-man. They're trying to keep him in front, make him shoot it over the top.
Granger going strong, drawing the foul. This one will be on the floor. It'll be on Middleton as the sophomore picks up his first personal foul.
Well, I said Middleton has a couple fouls to give. He just gave him a couple fouls
on one play.
Now he's got to watch it. Yeah, I mean, it's just a tough matchup. I mean, for anybody at this level, that Jordan Granger's a tough matchup. You see Galen Brown knocking down the jumper. That's the guy that's got to get more involved if you're McClure North. He's your senior leader. He's the conference player of the year. He's got to get more involved.
Yeah, Galen Brown now in the ballgame with that bucket has 6 points. Had 20 the other night. Nice pump fake. Pump Middleton fake. Off the glass and scoring.
How about that? Two pump fakes. Had McClure North guy flying all over the gym.
So, yeah, it was Middleton getting the hoop that time. He's also playing with those two fouls. From outside, Ray missing the shot. Rebound taken away by Bundy. With that head up, looking to fire the alley-hoop, and Norman just a little high and went off his hands. Actually, a pretty good pass.
Right
he
on the money.
Didn't handle it.
Right on the money.
We'll take timeout. Back to the state title games right after this. This is the Show Me Showdown here in Columbia.
From the gridiron to the hardwood. On the links or on the track. On the diamond or on the ice. Go to prepfilms.com. It's easy. You can order your DVD online. At prepfilms.com, you make the memories. We'll make them last forever.
Well, when you teach textbook basketball, take a look at Wes Middleton, the 6'4 sophomore, came off the bench. Watch the bounce pass. One pump fake. Jordan Granger goes flying. Another pump fake. There goes Galen Brown. That is textbook post play. Kevin McHale would be proud.
And paratroopers here at Mizzou Arena. Guys flying everywhere. That's the first field goal in the last 1:47 of the second quarter. Back to that time, last 6 minutes and 13 seconds. That's their first field goal. Here's the shot. Norman went to get his own, and one for Norman.
Well, he's active. We said Galen Brown's got to be more involved for McClure North. Jalen Norman's got to be involved in this game. To win a state championship, you need your star, Jalen Norman and Austin Reuter, to take you to the promised land. And very aggressive that time, strong enough to go up with the left hand and finish. He plays a lot bigger than the 6'5 that he is.
Yeah, he's a double-double guy. 16 points over 10 rebounds. He's the single season record holder for rebounds, more than 300 this season for this Nixa team. He can't complete the three-point play. And we are tied at 35. Swing it over, Galen Brown with the left hand, getting it to go. The quarterback in football, who is going to play at Hutch Community College next season.
Well, right on cue, I kind of called him out and said he needs to get more involved. Two buckets in the last minute.
He slashed away on that one, and he has 8 points now. Bundy between the defense, draws the foul.
Well, Bundy is crafty with that basketball. He's real herky-jerky with it, kind of stops and goes, and likes to jump stop through the defenders. Tough matchup.
Yeah, very tough guard. I mean, he's a guy that can hit that shot if you lay off of him, but he seems to be able to get wherever he wants to with his drive, and there's a shot, Norman. No good. There's Reuter flying in and scoring.
Just to show you, I'm not just a jump shooter.
Yeah, he's done it in a number of ways here. In the first half, he hit 4 3 balls. In the second half, he's got a couple of twos in a couple of different ways.
Yeah, he's a hard-nosed kid.
Three ties here in the second half, tied at 37 right now. On the move, Garrett. And that's too easy on his way to the rim that time.
Yeah, it looked like Bundy might have gotten hurt trying to guard Garrett. And he's down.
Oh, he's in a lot of pain over there. Cameron Bundy looks like he's going to be able to shake this one off. We look again.
Couldn't really tell. Looks like he got hit maybe in the midsection. Then he knocked the air out of him. Hopefully that's all it is.
Well, that's why it was so easy. Got bumped off the play like that, and it was a free run for Garrett. Bundy will sit down. Looks like he's going to be okay, though, and be able to check back in for all the Nixa fans. Hocklander is in there replacing him. He's got the ball up top. Over to Middleton. He's still pump faking. Leaves it back for Reuter.
He's like, I'm not going to go up against Granger. He already bought my last pump fake. I don't think he's buying it again.
He heard you calling Kevin McHale, and he's going to town
he's
now.
He's fired up.
Austin Reuter, too strong on this one. Norman fighting for it. And this one will go over to McCluer North. The Nixa fans don't like that call.
All of Nixa is screaming at the officials. They did not like that one. Neither did Coach Osborne.
Little torque and pressure here from Epps as Ray brings it up.
Again, you got Middleton, Granger. Granger should be able to get around, but Middleton doing a good job fronting Granger on the post.
But Galen Brown has been taken over.
Yeah, that's his game. That mid-range game, coming off that high screen, getting 15, 16 feet. That's vintage Galen Brown.
He's got 10 points now. Epps leaves it for Hocklander. Rebound Ray at only 5'8", the senior, and they are gone. Garrett ate up the floor in a hurry and served it in with the left. He's got 4 points.
I didn't have a stopwatch, but I think it was about 2.5 seconds, 94 feet end to end.
I think you could line up a few of these guys and get your 400-meter relay team right here. Except they're going strong with the basketball.
Yeah, watch how quick they go from defensive rebound. The lead pass to Garrett gets to the other end just literally so quick in transition off that long rebound. Defensive transition was one of the things Jay Osborne was really concerned about.
Reuter missing this shot.
Here they come
again. Long rebound to Garrett. Dealing off Granger. Oh, man! Right down central and draws the foul.
See, what happens when you shoot long shots, not a particularly good shot that time, you get long rebounds, which then start fast breaks. You saw it 2 times in a row. Poor shot by Reuter. McCluer North gets out in transition. The big fellow runs the floor, shows a lot of agility to finish it.
Yeah, great point, Scott. That's almost like an outlet pass that bounced way out there, except for Granger didn't have to throw it, so he got in on the break.
Yeah, these guys are just taking off, and McCluer North loves nothing better than to get out, fill the lanes in transition. They do that very well.
Granger now with 21. So his first points in the second half make it 22 with the free throw. 22 and 11 here in the state title game. And we got plenty of game left as we approach the end of the third quarter.
Take a look at that matchup. They got Keith Jones on Jalen Norman. Norman should be able to go to work on Jones on the low block, but they've got to be patient and find him.
Yeah, he is a load, Keith Jones, in there. He's headed to Tennessee Martin to play football, defensive tackle. In there wearing number 55 and bumping guys all over the place in there.
He's putting some body love on Mr. Norman down there, but Jalen Norman can't stand. He's got to work and demand the basketball. There it is.
And King right with him. Reuter rings out. Rebound Granger. Up the floor, Granger got in the flow again off the glass, knocked out by King. Well, looks like Nixa knocked it out. And it will stay with McCluer North, 9.1 on the clock.
Well, you can feel the tempo really in McCluer North's favor. They're really getting out, getting running, getting in transition. Even when they miss, they're crashing the offensive glass. That's what Randy Reed wants from his team.
Well, this is a 9-0 run. It was tied at 37. And now they've run off 9 in a row. Here's Brown off the inbound. Got him another one. He has a dozen. Epps quickly lets it fly. And And that's your third quarter with that bucket by Galen Brown. His 12th point. It's an 11-point lead here in the state championship game for McCluer North. You're watching 2012 Show Me Showdown. Back right after this. Looking into that McCluer North huddle, head coach Randy Reed says the key to winning the state tournament, winning that title game, is have some luck with avoiding some injuries down the stretch and all those kind of things as the season goes on, and also have some strong key leaders, and he's got that in Galen Brown and Jordan Granger.
Yeah, it was Granger in the first half, and that third quarter, it was all Galen Brown, has 12 points. And really led that 11-0 run to finish that third quarter.
And don't leave out Byron Ray. He's also a senior, 5'8". He hadn't scored much, hadn't scored at all in this ballgame. Had 19 the other night, but he has 5 assists dealing it out to these guys.
Nice job distributing the ball.
Brown from outside, missing the shot this time. Rebound there by Norman, who really has not gotten into the flow in this game yet. Reuter dealing off. Epps pump faking everybody, and Granger went up there to cap it.
Yeah, Granger's just ever present. He's everywhere on the defensive end. Another turnover by McCluer North, but they don't mind that because this is the tempo that they want.
Yeah, Epps stole it right back. Here's Austin Reuter. They've missed their last 5 threes over the last 2.5 minutes. But not this time. That is Jordan Epps for his second three.
Boy, they needed that just to stem the tide a little bit. Now Nixa puts some full court pressure.
And that foul will be on Bundy, who's obviously okay. Checks back in there. They will need the senior down the stretch here in this one. 7-12 as we're just underway here in the fourth quarter.
You know, I think shot selection had a lot to do. Poor shot selection by Nixa really led to a lot of those transition points that McCluer North was talking about. You've got to believe Jay Osborne talked to his team about making sure you get the shot that you want every time. A little run and jump, a little half-court trap.
Yeah, as they trap out of that, looks like a zone defense. And now McCluer North takes it out. They're going to work a little clock here.
Interesting. No shot clock here in high school basketball.
Well, they do have an 8-point lead. Granger goes down low as they work it well to Dorian Holland.
Well, Jordan Granger's obviously showed us he can score, but he's a nice passer, sees the floor, good hands.
Austin Reuter up over the top of Granger. He nearly got that one to go. And here come the Stars.
See how Granger affects every shot. Even when you get in the lane, you think you got an open look, you got to throw it way higher than you really want to. Really affects a lot of shots that don't show up on the stat sheet.
And lest you think this is just a run-and-gun team, McCluer North, they showing you a little discipline to back it out. Here they go. They get another hoop in their half-court set.
See if Jay Osborne doesn't get a timeout. Feels like this one's almost getting out of hand.
Yeah, this is the largest lead of the game right now of a dozen. 52-40, and Nixa calls timeout. Let's go over to Sophia.
Neil and Scott, if we were looking for some notes on Nixa or needed a scouting report, I think we should have gone to Denzel Morris. He has been the clock keeper for Nixa for 38 years. He was a student at Nixa, was the student manager as a senior when they were state runners-up in 1974, and he has not missed a home game in 38 years. He said, I asked him about the road games. He said he had maybe missed eight, but that's about it. And he said, whether we win this one or lose this one, he said, I still think this is the best program that Nixa has ever seen. He said, we are so proud of these boys, what they've done, and for Coach Osborne as well.
All right, Sophia, thank you. Thanks for that insight. How about that? Guy watching all those games, and they have a lot of tradition there at Nixa. And they certainly have had a great run this season, and don't think this game is over yet, for sure. These guys can score in bucketfuls. Even though they trail 12 with just under six to play, they can score in a hurry.
Oh, yeah, they're explosive. And you think about this team, you know, the Reuter's a junior, his brother's a freshman. Norman's only a junior, so it's going to be a force to be reckoned with for the next couple years.
No question. There goes Norman. And he's had to shoot it maybe a little higher than normal because of the 6'8 presence of Granger, and that may have bothered him a little bit in this ballgame tonight.
A little higher, a little quicker, just not used to playing against that kind of length.
And now here's Granger, a guy that can come out and help you handle a little bit when you're working clock. But there's a steal by Reuter.
What a pass.
Long bounce pass. Oh, my goodness. Bundy finished off.
How about a one-handed bounce pass through traffic by Austin Reuter?
These two teams are fun to watch here in the state title game. Norman the rebound. And he's moving with it. Reuter to the rack with the left. It won't go. Granger the rebound. That's his 14th board of the game. And they lead that category. The Stars do 35-21.
That's a big stat. They are dominating on both ends of the floor on the glass.
Holland, that's an offensive foul on Dorian Holland. Third foul on Holland, 15th foul on McClure North.
Again, Reuter gets in the passing lane off that screen. Take a look at this pass. Threads the needle, kind of gets deflected onto Cameron Bundy. And Dorian Holland, again, they like to post him. Good position that time on the post.
Hocklander took the charge. Try to go to Norman. He runs it down to the baseline. Finds an open Bundy. Four straight points by Nixa. Timeout, Randy Reed and McClure North. He can feel a run coming. He wants to stop it right now.
Well, partner, you said they're not going to go away. And these guys have had too much success, won 30 games in a row. They've got too much pride to let McClure North stretch this lead out anymore. Take a look. Norman gets double teamed. Nobody checks Bundy on the other side. And again, another thing Jalen Norman can do, he's got good vision out of that post.
Well, it'll be fun to watch him as his career progresses, because when you possess those kind of skills, that's why I kind of think he can go out on the floor a little bit.
You know, I'm going to show my age here. There's a guy, another guy by the name of Norman, Kenny the Snake Norman, that played at Illinois. Kind of looks like this Norman, 6'5", 6'6", a little bit undersized, but so athletic, very strong. I mean, this kid's only 16, 17 years old. What's he going to look like, his body, in 4 or 5 years? Very explosive athlete.
The Snake.
The Snake. You remember the Snake?
I do. I remember
him. I don't know if you're old enough to remember the Snake.
Dude. Hey, I might go back and start talking about guys you never heard of. Back when the film was black and white. All right. We got McClure North breaking huddle after their conversation with Randy Reed. And again, these two veteran coaches, man, they have such a feel for the game. Coach Reed knew that he needed to get a timeout right there, talk things over, and stop the flow that Nixa was in.
Yeah, see if they don't work a little clock, see if they get 25 a touch.
And he goes right to Granger. They double-teamed him. Rebound, Holland. How about the game Holland's had tonight?
Yeah, you talk about a guy who plays bigger than he is. He's only 6'3", but they're posting him. He's getting offensive rebounds. Really working hard on the offensive glass. Watch him. See the work that he did before that ball went up? He used his bottom, got some position. That's what you got to do, young kids. It's not all about just jumping over guys. You got to get that inside position.
The other thing, Scott, he came into the game averaging just over 6 points a game on the season, and he's got now 12 points in the game. So it just really elevated his effort here tonight. 13 points in the ball game now, also 5 rebounds. Back to a 10-point game.
around his world, off the glass and scoring, Jordan Epps.
It's one of those ones where Jay Osborne goes, no, 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 yes, exactly what I drew up.
And they have three guys in double figures. There's a steal, Reuter. 18 now for Reuter. He cuts the lead to six. And a foul in the backcourt. This one going on Bundy. 16 points off turnovers now. And McClure North has turned it over eight times. Timeout on the floor. Nixa coming back to within six. Don't go away in the title game here.
Distracted driving. It accounts for 25% of car crashes. Music, cell phones, food, the list goes on.
This is why safe driving is so important.
Correct.
And it's why the best agents help safe drivers get a lower rate.
Oh, exactly.
We are insurance.
We are Farmers. Bum, ba, bum, 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 bum.
Welcome back to Mizzou Arena. We're in a good one. Six-point lead for McClure North. Let's go over to Sophia.
Neil and Scott, talking with Coach Randy Reed last night, he said, sure, we can run the floor with the best of them. We can run and gun. But we're also very smart, cerebral basketball players. He pointed to the semifinal last night saying they had a few possessions right around a minute where they were holding on to the ball and waiting to get the shots they wanted. He says they use a drill at districts where they just practice situations every day, up six, down six, with certain amount of minutes on the clock. And he said that has helped us tremendously through the playoffs. I wouldn't be surprised if we saw more of that smart situational basketball here from McClure North.
A great point, Sophia, and they showed us that the other night, but this time they turn it over. That's their ninth turnover on the ball game. And here comes Epps with it. Into the lane, back to Reuter. From the parking lot!
You're not going to get a better look than that. Drew the defense and got it to their pure shooter. Cut it to three. And surprisingly, McClure North looks really shaky against their pressure.
Another turnover going back the other way to Nixa. This is a three-point ball game.
You know, the old adage is that teams that press don't like to be pressed. And surprisingly, McClure North looks very rattled against the pressure of Nixa.
Well, the Nixa faithful on their feet here at Mizzou Arena. It was once a 12-point lead. That lead has been eaten up now to a three-point lead for McClure North. Nixa has the basketball. Austin Reuter now has 21. Epps and Bundy have 12 each. For McClure North, Granger has 22, Brown has 12, and Holland has 13. And we buckle up for a stretch run now inside 3 minutes to play.
Well, this is the money time. This is where you're going to either Jalen Norman or Austin Reuter. You've got to make sure your stars get a touch every possession now.
And those points off turnover, really cashing it in. Reuter from way downtown has tied the ball game.
Beautifully designed play out of the timeout.
And a foul on Nixa.
Well, I was going to say, they were getting close to a 10-second call as well. Well, that pressure really bothering McClure North.
Six threes for Austin Reuter now. Coach Osborne has seen that before. Out of his star junior guard, 6'2", Austin Reuter, now with 24 points and at the line. This is the guy that's had the real solid ball game here tonight, and that is Holland. They have made all their free throws now, 6 out of 6, and Holland is 4 out of 4. Has 14 points, 5 rebounds.
Well, for McCluer North, it's all about playing with composure. They've made their run. Now you've got a 2-point lead. If you told Randy Reed, 2-point lead, 2 minutes, 30 seconds, he'd have taken that all day.
And remember, that guy stroking him home in the state title game is a sophomore, Holland. Here's Reuter, who showed you that his range is unlimited. The Nixa fans know that already. Each team with only one loss this season coming into the title game. Up top, Bundy. From way outside, it rings out for Edie. And here comes McCluer North, up two. 2-on-1. Holland can't get that one, but Granger does. Granger with 24 and 15 rebounds.
It's really important that they get the shot they want.
Too strong by Reuter. And out of bounds. And a foul down there, and it's going to be on Nixa. And we come the other way to shoot free throws. That is the 8th team foul on Nixa. It'll be Ray shooting the free throws. The foul is on Norman, his 3rd. Ray missing the free throw, front end of the 1-and-1. On the move, Epps into the lane, draws the foul. That is the 16th foul on McCluer North. This one, I believe, is on the floor, although he's lining up to shoot free throws. And I would, too, if I shot 88% from the free throw line. They are going to take it out from underneath the hoop down there. Epps is 88% on the season. Owen stolen away off the inbound. And then a quick foul on Nixa.
Well, those are the unforced turnovers that you just can't afford. Down 4 minutes and 30 in the state championship game. You just can't afford that. Just too risky a pass that time. Trying to get the ball down low to Cameron Bundy. The risk reward not real good on that one.
And that's only the 4th turnover on Nixon in this ball game against this team, McCluer North. That's impressive. But they're down. They trail it by 4. And they have their star senior at the line, one of them, and that's Galen Brown. I always like to ask the coaches who they'd pick in a pickup game to go play. Coach Reed said, this guy right here, player of the year in the conference, Galen Brown. He buries 2 free throws in crunch time here and extends that lead to a half dozen. Reuter dealing off Norman. Norman going to work inside with a pump fake. They wave it off. The foul is on the floor. 7th team foul, so 1-and-1.
Oh, boy, that could have been a big bucket and one that time. Dorian Holland actually played pretty good defense. Watch him move his feet. Just chest him just a little bit. Gets called for that bump right before the basket.
Foul number 3 on Holland. And to the line, Jalen Norman. And he misses the front end. 6-point lead as we approach 1 minute to play.
Now to McCluer North, you got nothing but a wide open layup. Make him come out and chase you. Keep the ball in your ball handler's hands. You're good free throw shooters. Byron Ray, really their leader out on the perimeter.
Double bonus now on that foul, Austin Reuter. As he picks up his 2nd personal foul, and to the line, it is Byron Ray. He missed last time in the front end of the 1-and-1. He's a 71% free throw shooter on the season. He's got this one down. 6 of 8 from the line in the semifinals.
Yeah, had 19 points in that semifinal game.
And this now an 8-0 run over the last little more than 2 minutes.
1 minute.
Bundy works his way into the lane. The turnaround jumper gets the roll. And Bundy with 14. Timeout Eagles. And the lead cut back down to 6 with 52.8 left. And as we look into that huddle, Scott, Coach Osborne keeping his team motivated. What do you think the strategy is here?
Well, they need to play with the same type of intensity on the defensive end that they did a couple minutes ago when they really had McCluer North rattled on the defensive end. They ran that ran and jump. They got in passing lanes. And at this point, you might give it a couple passes, but if you don't get a steal, you're going to have to go ahead and foul and extend this game, make it a free throw shooting contest. But you want to have at least one or two passes, try to get a steal and turn it over.
And then for McCluer North, what do you think Randy Reed was telling his team? You know, they've been very composed in the semifinals down the stretch. They regained their composure here with that little run.
One of the adjustments that he's made against this pressure is bringing Jordan Granger down there, using his size as an outlet. Let him come catch it. He also shoots free throws well. So a lot of times you're letting Granger catch it and then get it back to a guard.
Yeah, that's nice to have an athletic 6'8 guy that you can toss the ball to when trying to get it inbounds on the press. They trap in the backcourt, having trouble. Then there's a foul on Nixon. And once again, walking to the free throw line, it will be Galen Brown, who has 14 points, 6 rebounds, and 2 assists. That foul is on Jalen Norman. And Galen Brown will visit the free throw line. 64% on the season. But he's been stroking them home here in crunch time. 3 straight.
He's a pretty cool customer. That's what you expect out of your senior leader.
Galen Brown, 4 straight free throws here in the state championship game, inside a minute to play. And the lead is 8. Bundy draws the foul on the floor. And that will put him at the free throw line for 1-1. That's team foul number 8. The foul's on Granger, his 3rd. Boy, Randy Reed trying to get this one to the clubhouse. If they do, 2 straight state championships. This Nixa team knows it's not over yet with the way they shoot the basketball. And the way they've been coming up with steals in this ball game, they have 7 steals in the game here tonight. Bundy hits the first free throw. He's got 15 points. Make it 16 with 2 free throws. 2 possession ball game. Get it into Granger. There's a foul on Norman. That's 5 on Jalen Norman. And he's out of here.
Yeah, that really hurts Nixa on both ends of the floor. And we talked about how they're McCluer North using Granger to come catch. And that young man has a bright, bright future. Mr. Norman's going to play a lot more basketball in his day and certainly going to be able to play at the next level. Good-looking young man, good-looking athlete.
Yeah, absolutely. Tough ball game here tonight as far as his numbers go. Normally, I mean, he's 16-10 normally. Tonight, 4 points, 6 rebounds. Fouls out with 36 seconds left. A lot of that had to do with the guy at the free throw line right now, and that's a senior, Jordan Granger. Norman will be back next season.
That's something to learn from. You see what a high major Division I recruit looks like, and he's on the free throw line right now. 6'9", strokes the ball. Really showed us his whole arsenal tonight.
Yeah, 25 points now, 16 rebounds. 26-6. Headed to Auburn next season. 80 from outside. The left-hander, it rings out. Put back Bundy. He's got 18. Another quick timeout by Nixa. They've got 1 more left after this.
Well, it's just a 2-possession game, so you get extended if you're Nixa. Try to make it a free throw shooting contest. Try to keep it out of Jordan Granger's hands. Take a look. The long 3, and Cameron Bundy's as athletic as anybody out on the floor. Great offensive rebound. He's got good explosiveness going to the basket, and they're trying to figure out who they can foul. But you look at Ray, 69%, Garrett, 64%, Granger, 67%. They all shoot it decent out on the floor.
How about tonight, Scott? 15 out of 16.
Pretty darn good.
Pick your poison here tonight.
Yeah, for a team that only shoots 63% as a team.
That's clutch. And on the other hand, Nixa They're a 72% free throw shooting team. Number one, they've only been there seven times, and they've only hit two here tonight. And McCluer North has scored on six of their last seven possessions. And that's how they've been able to maintain this lead, which is a half dozen right now.
See, again, Granger comes and catches. Dangerous pass across the floor, though.
And they didn't go for the foul. Got to get the ball off the half court here, and they finally do.
You don't have time to mess around. If you don't get a steal in the first one, maybe two passes, you've got a steal. They just let about 8 seconds go off the clock.
Galen Brown at the line. As that foul was on Hocklander. Galen Brown, 16 points, 6 rebounds, 2 assists, 4 of 4 at the line.
You know, free throw shooting is contagious, just like anything else. You get in a rhythm, and Galen Brown keeps coming back to the line. He's got that good feel, that good rhythm, and really looking good at the line right now.
18 for Galen Brown. 8-point lead for Randy Reed's McClure North Stars. Shot no good there by Epps. And they run down the rebound with Garrett, and a foul in the backcourt going on Bundy. And now the McClure North faithful standing and cheering behind the bench. Randy Reed knows he's got it.
He can feel it.
The double high five to the assistant coaches over there.
How about that? 3 state championships in the last 5 years.
That's impressive.
Let's get it done.
And you know what this is the key here, and credit to all of them, the players first, because they're the ones out there playing the game. They lose these star players year in and year out, and here they come back. That's also a credit to coaching staff to get the new mindset ready to go without the star player.
To be able to do it back-to-back in particular is just incredible. Losing a guy like B.J. Young, just great focus all season long for McClure North.
McClure North, back-to-back state titles here at the Show Me Showdown. Randy Reed, state title in 2007, 2008.